game. Again, stay in the game, y'all.
Stay in the game.
I know it was bad now. Folks are dying, and you hear all these cases about the coronavirus infecting people. But y'all, let's stay in the game.
Stay in the game.
Because stay in the game, we're going to win. And if we lose, we'll learn something that will aid us in winning the next time.
Yeah. And see, just like I'm going to piggyback off what my co-host said, Mr. Travis, you know, you got to keep your eye on the opponent, man. You know, you got to, because if you don't, you know, it's just like the Rocky movie. And I'm going to give you two good examples. There's two boxers that I probably would never step in the ring with, but I probably would if that was me. You know, if I was Apollo Creed, I probably would have took Dragoff differently. Because, number one, he's a Russian boxer. Number two, he takes synthetic steroids. Number three, he empowered himself by enhancement drugs to make him stronger and ability to hit harder and to knock his opponent to oblivion. Now, Rocky Balboa, on the other hand, trains naturally. You know, he used the environment, you know, but it's not how you work out. And it's not about who trains you. It's about having a mindset to be ready to fight your opponent. Prime example, Apollo Creed overconfident himself when he thought he could take Dragunov. You see, and this is the downfall, because the weakness is Dragunov's gut. So when you focus on other tactics fighting him, you have to understand, people, you know, when it comes to time where you get overconfident, when you think you can take full advantage of something, but you don't really know what you're trying to take advantage of, or you don't know who you're facing, or you don't know who you're fighting. But I would have handled Dragunov differently. What I would have did was just kept moving around the post, the ring. Because I know he's going to stand in one spot until his Russian trainer tell him to attack. So now, Dragunov swinging. Now we got him out the way. We know what type of opponent he is. Now, we're going to move on to Clubber Lion. Now, Clubber Lion been watching Rocky Balboa fighting his rings and fighting his matches before he became a contender, you know, to fight against Balboa. But look what he had to do to get Balboa in the ring. But this time, Apollo Creed was alive. So, when you overconfidence in the midst of your battle, it's all right, but you gotta stay in the game. You gotta stay in the game, because if you overconfidence, and it can happen. It can happen sometimes when you get excited and you're seeing, you know, the lights, stuff like that. But these two fighters was dangerous in the move, until Rocky had to find a weakness on both fighters. Dragoff, he even had to find a weakness on his friend Paulo. When they fought, you know, before they became friends.
Yeah.
You know. But it's all about, you know, staying in the game. And it's not about getting up, giving up. And it's not about, you know, seeing things like, well, it's going to be a gloomy day today. I just guess I'm just basically just going to do nothing. Just all of my pettiness. It's nothing for me to do. But that's when you're giving up. But if you're confident, then you'll know what to look for, and you'll know exactly what to do. So just stay in the game.
And don't be, it's okay to be, don't be overconfident, but don't think that you can't win either.
Gotta have a balance.
Gotta have a balance. Because you gotta know your skill set. I know what you bring to the table. Because sometimes when we take down and knock down so many times, we begin to feel like there's no way I can win. But there is a way to win. Like you said, you can learn from the mistakes that you made in the battle while it's going on.
Yeah.
So I would say that we need to have confidence. We need to have confidence in ourselves. We need to know our opponent, and we need to know what we got to do to win. You know, it's almost like a football game. If you down 2 touchdowns, there's a chance for you to run the ball up there and make a touchdown.
Yep.
If there's enough time.
And you stay in the game.
Stay in the game. Because if we stay in the game, we just may win.
Mm-hmm.
We just may win. There's a chance. It may be a small chance, it may be a big chance, but there's a chance.
Yep.
There's a chance. Like, some people are so scared until they want to leave the house. Now you with the mask and gloves on. That fear cripples them.
Mm-hmm.
To the point where they say coronavirus as the big bad wolf. But in the story of the big bad wolf, the third pig built a house out of bricks.
Yep.
And the buck and the wolf huffed and he puffed. And he cut my blood house down. And then the wolf came down the chimney.
Mm-hmm.
But that pig was smart enough. But that pig was smart enough for the fire. Until the wolf hit the fire, and he could not get to the pig.
Mm-hmm.
Is our house made of hay? Wood or brick? That's the question.
Mm-hmm.
If I'm at a hay, that wolf gonna and blow it down.
Mm-hmm.
This made of wood, gonna blow it out again. But if I'm at a brick, the big bad wolf of the world cannot get to us. He may do all that. He do all that talking like, "I'm gonna mess you up. I'm gonna take your house. I'm gonna take your family.
Well, I'm gonna blow your house down.
Go blow your house down. I'm gonna take your job. Gonna take your car." But he can't do nothing to us if our house is made of brick.
Yep.
Because it took some time for that pig to be out of brick. He had to put the mortar down, put the brick, mortar down, brick. And I'm sure that pig got tired from building that house. But the pig's hard work paid off because he had a house that the wolf could not blow down. So to stay in the game takes hard work.
Work and dedication pays off. And one thing that we must know about that wolf story, it might sound like it's not true, but it is. It's basically true. It's, you know, it's a little storybook for children to learn, you know, for us to understand when we was little about how bad things is trying to conquer our mind, better off conquering our world. And see, if we let it in takes a strong mind and dedication, like I was speaking earlier. Strong mind and dedication to not give up on your fundamentals. And also not to let people lure you out of your standards. And not letting people control your domain. And what I mean by controlling your domain is not letting them get in your cerebral, your head. Because when you playing a game, a basketball game, or any sports, people are going to try to talk you out of your game. And either because of two things, either because they don't want you to win, so they can get the victory, or they want to knock you out your concentration so you can easily give up the victory. But when you don't give up the victory, you stand out. As others see that you're not scared, you're not nervous, that you do handle things according to the way it's supposed to be, accordingly, held. And one thing about life is that sometimes people don't want to be held accountable for several things. I feel if it's your fault, you should be held accountable. If I kill this man or whatever the case may be outside, and I have that determination to do it by not giving up, then I should be held responsible. I think premeditated mind on anything of causing harm in people should be responsible for that. Because it's sad that how this world is already, if you can't lock up a tornado for destroying a half of the city, people still die, right? If you can't lock up a tsunami by going to the ocean, people still die. If you can't lock up nobody, if you can't lock up electricity, but people still die. You can't lock up natural disasters, but people still die. But the way this world is run, it's like the weather could be forgiven because it's natural. But at the same time, you're supposed to be conscious to take cover. So people say, well, I can blame the lightning for striking my 9-year-old sister. But why would you plan it like that? Because it's a natural disaster. You will get struck 17 times before you can blame it. People get, environmental stuff can kill you. But if you have a determination to not give up in life, then you will know your morals, your standards, and what your purpose is. Because some of us don't know our purpose. Some of us, you don't know why we're here. But at the same time, we getting to know, that side and wondering, what is our purpose? What is our standard? Like if you go to school and your teacher asks you where you want to be when you grow up, and you say, I want to be a fireman. She expecting to see you as a fireman. Well, the next time she see you within 10 or 20 years from now and you something else, she might feel a little disappointed because she felt that she didn't do her job. But at the same time, people is going to be people. And people are going to like what they like. And people are going to do what either need to be done or either told to be done or just basically doing off the absence because they know that they need to and it's the right thing to do to serve the purpose for the world. But the world is going to spin 24/7, 8 hours, 365 days all over the world. The world's going to spin. But what happens in the world is 98% part of our control. 99% of the world does not pretty much know. I don't know why I'm saying this, but at the same time, I'm just, I'm looking at it like this. As the world spins 365 days since it's been in the universe, since God created heavens and earth. And ever since that world been spinning, a man died, a child is born. A man died, a child is born. A child died, a man is born. A man died, a child is born. You see the cycle? So as long as women can reproduce generations, generations and generations and so on. Even ones that can't reproduce, they always adopt. But even if you adopt or reproduce, you still carrying on a legacy of a generation that you can mold, that you can watch, that you could teach. But some people are just unteachable.
And I'm going through a story about the Red Sea.
Mm-hmm.
It looked damn for them. They had Pharaoh in the back. They had mountains on both sides, and they had water in front of them. And God asked Moses, "What's in your hand?" Moses says, "That rod, that same rod they put down and turned to a snake in front of Pharaoh.
Yep.
That same rod that was a walking stick.
Uh-huh.
And God say, "Lift it up."
Lift it up.
He lifted up the Red Sea party. The winds came and created walls.
Yep.
And it dried the water for them to walk across.
Yep.
You see, it looked bad for them. It looked like they were down for the count. They had an arm behind them and mountains on the right and left and water in front of them. But you know what? With God on our side, we should not give up.
Nope.
Just like that situation looked hopeless for them. But God made a way for them to come out of that.
Mm-hmm. Out of the wilderness.
Look at Daniel in the lion's den. Look at Daniel in the lion's den.
Yeah.
The king made a decree, if you pray to any besides me, go in the lion's den. Kept on praying. Kept on in the lion's den, and that was the best sleep they had in years.
Yes.
And you know what? His enemies, them and their families, got thrown in the lion's den.
Yep.
So just know that if we got God on our side, we have nothing to worry about. Nothing to worry about.
Nope.
It don't matter what the president say, what the doctor say, what your mama say, what your brother say.
What the world say.
What matters what God says about you.
Exactly.
And God's word says, "I'm an overcomer."
Yep.
God's word says, "I have a victory over anything that comes my way."
Yep.
But to do that, I must follow His will and His way. Walk in His word. If we want to be victorious in our lives, we got to do things God's way.
Yep. Good thing you said that, because just like I was about to say, when you mentioned about this Red Sea parture, let me go back on that story just a little bit. The thing we should be asking ourselves is we learning things what people say? Is we learning things what people show? Is we learning things the way what people talk, just like me and you are doing? But see, the thing is that it's an understanding in everything. But it's up to you to figure out which is the right understanding. Because we could easily be misled and we could easily be misguided if we don't keep our head in the game. Just like I said, if you playing basketball and y'all got a good run, and y'all won like 19 games, and here it is, y'all up to 34 games and winning, and you play your game for the championship season, and you got somebody in the championship season that's hungry than you, that's hungry than y'all team, because you got some divisions that are like that. You know, you got to watch the divisions, you got to watch the counters, you got to watch how people approach you. You got to watch how people step to you. You got to watch how people commend themselves to you. But you have kept seeing your mind, can they do the things that they said it was going to do for you in junior way as a friend, as a family member, as anything in life. If I give a proposal to say what I'm going to do for you, let's say for instance, if your birthday was next week or whatever, and I plan to do a cake and ice cream ahead of time, then that's the goal that I'm supposed to go for because it's your birthday. But your birthday is here, you see me, and we just down here sitting, the first thing you say, well, where am I cake and ice cream? Because you looking to be accommodated. So I have to be the one accommodated because I said I was going to do it. And since I say that's my word, then I have no choice but to do it. You know what I'm saying? But if I renege, then you have every right to be upset with me because, number one, I should never say what I was going to do for you if I ain't going to do it. See what I'm saying? But that's how people con. That's how people sometimes con you if you give up in your mind and you get out the game. But instead of staying in the game, you need to stay in the game. That way we can watch all covers and know who's playing us and who is for us. Because at the end of the year or at the end of the day or time, no matter, you will see who your true friends are.
And you know what? Sometimes people... You know, sometimes people try to talk us out because they see how we can grow or they see the power that's inside of us.
Yeah.
And they want to keep us from recognizing that. You know, if I see somebody who is better than me than at any sport, and I want to stay on top, what am I going to do? I'm going to make them feel like they're inferior.
Yeah.
I'm going to make them feel like they're nothing.
Yeah.
Because as long as they think they're nothing, they're nothing.
Exactly.
But if they see the power inside of them, they will possibly knock me off top.
Mm-hmm.
We live in a world where people want to stay on top. We live in a world where people want to keep their power. If they see somebody who has potential, they get scared, frightened.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Because they're afraid this person's gonna take their job.
Mm-hmm. You're easily terminated. And it's a good thing you said that. Because it, you know, and this is a good topic because we never had no topic about actually standing strong about don't give up and stand in the game. Now, I want to go back to your previous show that we did together. Our first show that we did together was talking about words are powerful.
Yes.
And as we know, this is day by day, each time the news shows something, the more power it has over us when we look at it. Because the coronavirus, you know, it's a fatigue, exhausting, you know, bacteria virus. But what we have to do as people, as much as these people want to accommodate the mask, okay, the mask should only be good to a certain period of time because should nobody be in it all day. You know, you got to look at, y'all got to look at the classifications here. I know the news is going to say you should wear your mask and it should be mandated. But to me personally, that man upstairs said it should be no mandate. That's what that man upstairs told me in my dream, in my visions. Do you know what my mask is right now? In my pocket. Because I'm staying in the game with God. I'm being connected to show so he can drive this vessel. See, we not letting him drive this vessel like we supposed to because we ignorant. Listen to something that's going to depress you all day. Like I said in my last topic, stop looking at the news. I'd rather pick up a Bible and get on my knees and talk to God before I look at Channel 2 News, Living Alive, Fox 5. The only thing I want to see, I don't even want to see the weather. Because even they lie about the weather. But we have to be understanding. We're going to let the news think for us, or we're going gonna drown. Because we let it consume us. If you keep, okay, put it this way. I understand about the mask. And I know some of y'all is gonna feel like, well, let me tell you something. You have to look back at this. The mask is really supposed to be for people who are sick. Now, I'm getting tired of people saying that you don't know who has it, you don't know who had it, don't show no sign of symptoms. Okay, that's understandable. But I'm gonna need y'all to stop trying to get me out my game, because I'm not giving up because y'all thinking that because y'all mind is consumed to the news, and that y'all mind is consumed to the 6 feet distance, and that y'all mind consumed. You know, I'm not saying it's a hoax, I'm not saying it's fake, but I'm just saying we still gotta live our lives. Okay? When you can't give up and surrender, don't focus on the news. The deaths is gonna always be a natural thing. We all gotta die someday, and we all gonna die for something. But as we here on this earth, hear me now, I'm gonna say it one more time. As we here on earth, we have a job to do. And our job is not to focus on coronavirus, okay? You got to live your life before it got here. Because a whole lot of stuff you're going to see way before this is going to get worse before it get better. But you have to understand and stay in the game. Because see, this is right here is what wakes you up, because God is in your conscience. If you don't wake you up, it's because he's talking to you, getting you prepared. And when you open your eyes, then you say, thank you, Yahweh, for waking me up this morning, starting me on my day. Let me get the day started since you woke me up. Notice what I said. I didn't wake myself up. I didn't say, thank you, Yahweh, for waking yourself up this morning. Now you can start your ass on your way. I said, thank you, Yahweh, for waking me up this morning, and you can start my day. I didn't say, our day. I said, my day, so you can start my day. I'm giving Yahweh the keys to drive this body. I don't drive this body. And everybody else should learn that. But if you don't know that, then of course you're going to be easily be stuck to the news and depressed what they say. We fighting over somebody that we don't even know. We got riots popping up for no reason. And this Black Lives Matter stuff is getting complicated. I feel y'all pain. But right now, we got to go back to the drawing board, man. Gotta stay in the game. Do you know why these deaths is happening? Because this is what we are. We blind to the fact that we accept anything that we can't see, but deny the stuff that we really need in our life that we can see. See the difference? The stuff that we can't see is what goes on in the world. The stuff that we are denying in the world that we can see is what God is trying to show us and what we're trying to tell us. Stay in the game.
And you know what? I don't want to go to stores. But when I was by myself, I don't have it on. Mm-hmm. Because can I give myself that virus?
No. No, you can't give yourself that virus.
And I was talking to somebody today, and they were afraid, but they made a point that should have gave them hope. They said the doctor said the person got the virus, but they're living well with no symptoms. They made the comment that their loved one was diagnosed with AIDS back in the day.
Mm-hmm.
And they said that this person, the doctor said, was when we die. But the person lived 10 years after that. Mm-hmm. That should tell us something.
Yeah.
That should tell us something. God had the final say, not man.
Not man.
Not the doctors.
Not the news.
But now, I'm not saying don't worry, go to stores. I'm not saying don't wear around people. But when you're in your house by yourself, be Because what you're doing, you're really in carbon dioxide to your body. You got that mask on. Mm-hmm. Because our bodies take in carbon dioxide in our lungs.
Yep.
Turn into oxygen for our bodies. So we got that mask on. We cannot expel that bad carbon dioxide from our bodies. Ask any doctor, they will confirm this. Mm-hmm. So when you buy yourself in your house, please take it off. Please. But again, I'm not saying we're going to public, don't wear it, okay? But I'm saying when you have to buy yourself, take it off. You know, my mom had a party this Saturday, and I'm gonna say this. Y'all may say I'm wrong, but my family was maskless. We were maskless. We were laughing and joking and having fun and doing things like that. But when we left out, we had our mask on to go out in public. Now I realize some family members got it, some members don't got it. But if we were only trusting God, don't trust in. I'm not saying discredit what they say, but I'm just saying our ultimate trust should be in God. Our ultimate faith and trust should be focused on what He says to us, what He says in our lives. That should be our ultimate focus. So what I'm saying, when you're by yourself, take it off. Open the door. Let some fresh air in. Open the window.
But if you open up the window, it's gonna require them to put back on their mask. No, I'm just kidding. Just a little sense of humor. But, you know, just like I say, you know, another thing, you got to have sense of humor. Because you got to have sense of humor within yourself. Because if you let stuff drain you, you is easily to be convulsively able to be taken advantage of. Because you get out of the game, just like you said, you know. You got some people outside that not wearing their masks. You got some people, yeah. You got some people that's inside that's pretty much, you know, that don't wear their mask. But in terminology, you know, the terminology is that when you are
going on
podcasting.
Okay,
but yeah,
don't be y'all thing.
All right. The terminology is to understand why you here. But let me take y'all back to 1955, okay? Let me see how y'all been concentrating, because this ain't the first. This is the first plague that hit the United States right now. But if I would have took y'all back to 1955, this plague don't require no mask. And so this plague comes on the skin, and it put holes on you, build sores, like warts. And when it gets on you, it's over with. And see, now you got the bionic plague coming out, and that's the yellow virus. It looked like pollen. So while y'all too busy focus on this, there's something else behind this that's way worse than this. See, some things you gotta understand that certain things certain thing happened for the prophecy. And see, the reason why I say that the news is very biased when it comes to natural disasters or when it comes to anything that they want to televise to get people to know, this have to pass. Joseph saw it in his vision. The people in Revelations, all this is Revelations right now. We is in Revelation. That's what we in. We is in the year of the Jubilee. The end of days. Not the end of days. Not the judgmental days where you see a Holocaust and fire falling out the sky. No, not that end of day. I'm talking about the Bible day. This is the Revelation. We already went through Jeremiah. Now we in Revelations. Okay? The prophecy must be revealed. Because this Bible finna turn this world into another thing that we ain't prepared for. And then I want to see how y'all gonna react different now. Because this ain't nothing but a prophecy revealing. Even though it's man-made, but you have to understand who has the last battle. You have to understand who's fighting for your battle. You have to understand that you're going to trust the world or you're going to trust in God. Okay? You're either going to be for the Bible God or you're going to be for the world God. Make your choice. You can't serve two masters. Okay? You're either going to let this take over your mind. Just because they say, stay home, what did God say do? Just because they say, do this, what did God say do? If the world telling you don't pray and God telling you to pray, what you gonna do? If the world tell you, you can't praise your master and you can't call to the Heavenly Father, only worship the devil, but you know who your creator is. Yeah, even the devil know that he's a child of God. Hello? Let me tell you, he was standing right next to Michael as one of the seven angels. Got kicked out of heaven because he tried to take over heaven. And since he couldn't get heaven, God gave him the world. That's why I say he had to make two sacrifices. The world that he created for Satan to have his kingdom and for him to bring down his forever guarded last son to save the people in the world so they won't follow the devil or follow Lucifer. But see, since the people is so love of the world and not love of God, they have to suffer with this virus. They have to suffer with this plague because they don't understand that it's a prophecy. It must fulfill its mission. I know people is dying behind this, but that's the only way to let you know of a wake-up call. It is serious, believe me, true enough.
Yes,
but I'm not finna take it as serious as y'all think taking it. I'm not finna worry myself sick and forget who my father is. No, I'm not finna be thrown off that way. I know who created me, and I know who made me. And at the same time, I know that he's gonna protect me in any kind of way. And if I shall fall, he should pick me up. If I should cry, he should wipe my eye. If I'm down and out, he lift my spirits. We got to start back from basics. Get back to square one. Know who your father is before you accept anything from the world and be deceived out of knowing who your father is. Because hell is real, but it's easy to go. It's harder to get to heaven, but it's easy to go to hell. Let's get that straight. You know? Because see, it takes so much work. You got to be damn near perfect to get to heaven. But you can also be damn near perfect go to hell too. Because if you follow the ways of the world, it's going to lead you there. But if you study God and understand that he'll make a way for you out of no way, and there's a will, there's a way. It says, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. So if you believe in God that it will be done on earth where you at, while this coronavirus is around, then it should be done as it is on heaven and earth. Because this is his world. He don't step into nothing that's filthy. Just like to us, we are filthy rags to him. I could tell him all day how good I've been, but only he knows how good I've been. I could tell him how honest I am. Only he knows how honest I am.
Sure enough.
I could tell him that I ain't did this and I ain't do that. But God watches all the time, so why would I lie to him? My friend said that she think I'm playing with God. And I told her I would never play with the Father like that. And one thing you gotta understand, you could either God mock or you could praise God. You could God mock or you could follow God. But it's up to you how you want to be deceived.
Hey.
I got you.
And Proverbs 7, it talks about how the world seduces us.
Mm-hmm.
It talks about a strange woman calling a young man to her bed. And she says, my bed has the Egyptian linens on it. She said, my husband took a big bag of mine and he not coming back no time soon. But that scripture says her bed leads to destruction.
Yeah.
Her bed leads to death. So what we're saying that the world's way leads to destruction. It leads to death. If you don't take anything else from this talk, take this. Do it God's way. Do it His way. If you don't take anything else from this, do things God's way.
Do things God's way.
Because God's way is the best way.
Yep, God is the best way.
Who else can speak in this world coming to a distance?
Nobody else.
Who else can speak and the world divides? The land and the world divide.
Mm-hmm.
Who else can form dust and blow its breath and man becomes a soul? Who can take a rib from Adam and make a woman?
Call Eve.
Who can cause the flood to flood the whole earth?
And who can create the heavens and the earth?
You know, even with the Big Bang Theory, there had to be a spark.
Mm-hmm.
Even with evolution, there had to be that one cell organism first.
Mm-hmm.
So these theories, they don't discredit God because there had to be something or someone that started that action to cause the world to be created.
Mm-hmm.
So if you don't take anything else from this, take from this, do things God's way. Whatever God tell you to do, do it.
Just do it. Yeah.
Because God's voice is the right voice.
Yep. And you can yes. And the time now, we're going to go with the time. The time now is 10:28. We about 54:05 in the recording.
Number is 678-749-3103. The email is podcasttolift7@gmail.com. That's podcasttolift7@gmail.com. The number again is 678-749-3103. If you have any topics that you want to hear about, you can contact us that right thank you guys for guys and thank you guys for listening to us.
Thank you guys for listening to us.
Without you, there would be no us.
No, it won't be no us.
Without you, there would be no us. And our goal is to lift you up. That's our goal.
Yeah.
Our goal is to make it where in those hard, so-called hard times,
right,
you'll have the strength, the power, and the fortitude to just empower yourself and say, I can do this. That's our goal.
Yep.
That's our mission.
And it looks like our radio station is giving us a heads up, and it's in red, so join us next time. Thank you for joining the Don't Give Up Hour of the G Podcast Network. I'm your host, Sue Nicole, and Mr. Travis Evans, a.k.a. I Don't Know. We're going to turn now because we at the end of our rope. Join us next time. This has been Open Topics 11. Stay tuned for Open Topics 12. I was going to stop at 10, but this is getting too good, so we got to keep the novel going. And again, thanks for tuning in. Like we said, without y'all, you know, we wouldn't be, you know, planning these things. Oh, quick thing. We still got merch and t-shirts on the way. I know it's been a while since I said this, since the first segment, but believe me, Vistaprint is working as fast as they can. So I'm just, you know, trying to, you know, be patient, and I also got other things coming in the mail as well. But the G Podcast and the Don't Give Up Hour is going to be going forever and ever. We're going to keep doing this, you know, until we build and build and build. So, again, thank you.
I just, like I always say, don't give up on your dreams, hopes, and visions. Please don't. Because I need you. The world needs you. We need you.
Mm-hmm.
We need you. We need to see God working in people's lives. We need to do that. We need to do that.
Yes, we do.
That's all.
And my words of encouragement, stay strong, stay in power. Stay strong, stay in power, and don't give up. Don't matter